Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning to the body of Christ. We are lifting his name on high this morning. The psalmist says, enter his gates with thanksgiving and enter his courts with praise and bless his name. Why? Because the Lord is good. Has he been good to you? And his mercy is everlasting. So we are lifting his name on high this morning. Again, good morning to the body of Christ and to our social media who visitors who are here with us this morning. Welcome to the Sunday morning worship experience of the Mount Calvary AME Church in Towson, Maryland, where our fine pastor is the Reverend Bobby B. Cox, Jr., and our First Lady is Reverend Angie Cox. We are glad you have made the choice to worship with us this morning. Oh, give thanks again unto the Lord, for he is good. We will open with our hymn of praise this morning, hymn 306, and it is entitled, King of My Life. King of my life, I crown thee now. Thine shall the glory be, lest I forget thy crown, thorn-crowned brow. Lead me to Calvary. And we need to think about this. This is Communion Sunday, the first Sunday in April, where we remember Jesus hung on the cross and did not come down. So he is the King of my life.
Thy crown.
God for that King of my life. We will now hear or be led in the invocation by Reverend Muriel Lucas, followed by the prayer response. And again, Reverend Muriel will read our scripture text for the day, followed by a selection from this wonderful communion choir. Amen.
Good morning, and thank you, God. What a beautiful day you've given us. Oh, how much your love pours out when we are in need of you. Lord God, we are so grateful. We love you for being who you are. I am so grateful that you know us so intimately. You know our every need. You know our every desire. But what's so wonderful is you're still being God. And it's your way. Thank you so much. Lord God, we come to you often because it seems we need you more. Once upon a time, we could put you on the shelf until maybe breakfast, lunch, or dinner and bedtime. But Lord God, right now I need you all day long. God, I am so grateful that you're there. We are people have been through so much. And downs and ins and outs. And you know what I found out, Lord God? You are always there. Thank you so much. Lord God, we've gathered in your house, God. We, your people, come to praise and thank you and to give you honor and glory, knowing, as sinful as I am, you'll never leave me. Now, Lord God, be with us from this moment on as we continue to praise and worship you all day long. Now, God, we sit back in anticipation of what you're going to tell us from our pastor this morning. Thank you, God. I know I missed some things, and but please, please, Lord God, continue to bless our sick, our shut-in, our bereaved, our lost souls. But most of all, Lord God, continue to bless our beautiful, wonderful children. Let us continue to encourage them to love you as you love us. This is my prayer this morning, Lord God. Thank you so much for listening. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Has said, streams of living water will flow from within him. Could we stand for the reading of God's word? This morning, our word will be coming from the book of Acts. Acts, the 17th chapter. And only one verse. Thank you, God, for your word. Acts the 17th chapter, verse 6, reads as thus. When they could not find them, they drug Jason and some of the brothers before the city's magistrates, shouting, these people who have been created in a disturbance, all people who have
have been created in a distance all over the world have come now. This is the reading of God's word.
Come on, clap your hands, everybody. How many can call on him when I need him? Abba, Father, he's up in heaven. I can go to God in prayer. Come on, put your hands together. Yeah. Makes no difference what the problem.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yes, I have this blessed assurance.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yeah. He will take my gloom and sorrow.
Into la.
He will never forsake me.
I can go to God in prayer.
I can call him.
I can call him
when I need.
Abba Father,
up in heaven.
Up in heaven.
I can go to God in prayer. Hello.
I can go to God in prayer.
Listen, y'all. Sometimes my burden, they get so heavy.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yeah, I found someone who is so faithful.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yeah, he will take my gloom and sorrow, turn it into light. He will never forsake me.
I can go to God in prayer.
I can call him,
when I need him.
Abba Father, he's up in heaven. I can go to God in prayer. Yeah, Lord,
I can go to God in prayer.
He can work it out. He can work it out.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Oh, yes, he can.
I don't have no doubt the Lord will work it out.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Oh, yes, he can.
I know what prayer can do. Prayer will see you through.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Oh, yes,
he
can.
I can call
when I need
it. Abba Father, up in heaven, I can go to God in prayer.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yeah, he can work it out. He can work it out.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Oh, yes, he can.
I don't have no doubt the Lord will work it out.
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Oh, yes, he can.
I can call.
I can call
when I need.
I can call.
When I need,
when I need,
I can call.
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 When I need
it, you can call it. When you need it, you can call it. When you need it, Abba Father, up in heaven, I can go. God in prayer,
I can go.
Oh, work it out, work it out, work it out,
work it out,
work it out,
work it out,
work it out,
work it out.
Work it out.
Work it out.
He can work it out. 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 I can call.
When I need.
I can call. When I need.
I
can call.
When I need.
Abba Father. Up in heaven,
I can go.
God in prayer,
God in prayer.
I can go. I can go to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Makes no difference what the problem.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yes, I have this blessed assurance.
I can go to God in prayer.
Yeah, He will take my gloom and sorrow, turn it into light. He will never forsake me.
I can go to God in prayer.
I can call when I need.
That's very important at this time. If you are parked in the apartment complex over by the side, adjacent from the parking lot, then you must move your car because it will be towed.
Thank you. Go to God in prayer.
Amen. God bless you. Somebody come on, give the Lord some praise in the house this morning. Come on, give the Lord some praise in the house this morning. I declare God is worthy to be praised. Oh, how I love Him. Oh, how I love. I just love to give Him the praise. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And my brothers and my sisters, we do want to be good neighbors. We do want to be good neighbors. We do want to be good neighbors to our neighbors in the complex in the back. So if you park by there, please, ma'am, please, sir, move your vehicle. And please be mindful of the fact that we, on Sundays, we do have permission to use the Crampton parking lot just up the street. It's a downhill walk to church. It's an uphill walk back after church. But I know that you're in a hurry to get to church, so it's a downhill walk. And so let us be mindful of the fact that we do need to be good neighbors to our brothers and sisters who live in the back of the church. So let us not park in their designated parking spaces, but let's use the parking spaces that we have and that the management of Crampton, the Crampton building has been so gracious to allow us to use on Sunday morning. Want to remind you that on next Sunday, on the 11th at 9 a.m., the youth and the adults Sunday school classes will meet in the Family Life Center for the first time in about 3 years. Amen. So we're looking forward to our church school meeting in person next Sunday, beginning at 9 a.m. in the Family Life Center. Next weekend is our homecoming weekend 2022. Amen. We are excited about homecoming 2022. Our youth will kick off the homecoming weekend with a youth explosion on Friday night, on September the 9th at 7 p.m. The elder T.J. Falcon would be here and he would be preaching the word. So we want you to come and support Elder T.J. He's not a stranger to us, for he came from among us. So we want to come back Friday night and we want to explode with the young folk on Friday night. Then on the 10th, on Saturday, in addition to having the blood drive beginning at 10 a.m., we will have Fun on the Yard beginning at 3 p.m. Fun on the Yard beginning at 3 p.m. of Saturday. That's the 10th of September. We will have food, fellowship, and fun. So we invite you to come and to share in that experience. Then on Sunday is our 133rd church anniversary. Yeah, for 133 years, we have been preaching, teaching, and serving the community of East Townsend. So we want you to be a part of that grand celebration with the stewards and the trustees on next Sunday as we celebrate our church anniversary. The Right Reverend John Richard Bryant, retired bishop, retired senior bishop in the African Methodist Episcopal Church, will be our preacher on next Sunday. And I declare that you don't want to die and go to heaven before you hear Bishop Bryant preach the word. Amen. So I want you to come and share and invite a friend, invite a neighbor to come and be a part of that celebration on that Sunday. And as always, my brothers and sisters, with our church anniversary, we pay $1 for every year that the church has been in existence. So our members, you know that we are expecting you to give $133 on that Sunday as a love offering, as a gift to Mount Calvary AME Church. Amen? Amen. On the 23rd of September, our youth ministry will present Open Mic Night at 7 p.m. If you're interested in being part of Open Mic Night, ask that you will contact our youth minister, Reverend Natalie, our YPD director, Sister Liz, to sign up, and they would be happy to have you to be a part of the open mic on Friday, September the 23rd. We ask that you continue to keep all of our sick and our shut-in lifted up in your prayers, and keep our bereaved in your prayers, and keep others who may just need a word or prayer in their lives. We ask that you would keep those persons lifted up as well, because as we always say, we believe and we know what the power of prayer can do in folk lives. So God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we join our faith with their faith. And we claim that it is so in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. This morning, we are delighted to have all of our guests to come and to share with us in our worship experience at this place that we call Mount Calvary. So if this is your first time, second time, third time, fourth time, fifth time visiting with us here as a guest, and your name is not on this particular church roll, will you please stand just wherever you are? If you're a guest with us today, amen. God bless you. God bless you. Indeed, we are blessed to have you to worship with us today, and we are glad that you did come our way. And as always, at the end of the service, we want you to be able to declare that the difference was worth the distance. Yeah, that the difference was worth the distance. So again, welcome, and please come back to see us real soon. Amen. God bless you. Let us now prepare to give our morning tithes and offering. Amen. Let us now prepare to give our morning tithes and offering, because I declare that you can't be God-given no matter how you try. The more you give, the more he gives to you. So just keep on giving, because it's really true that you can't be God-given no matter how you try, because the Lord has declared that the earth is his, and everything that dwells therein belongs to him. So you can't beat him giving no matter how you try. The Lord only asks that we give at least a tenth back to him what he has blessed us with. So my brothers and sisters, we pray that you will make your heart ready to give in a cheerful manner, because the Bible says the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So as you prepare now to give your tithes and your offerings, you can give in person just where you are today, in person in the sanctuary. You can give. You can mail your gift in to Mount Calvary Amy Church, P.O. Box 20416. That's P.O. Box 20416, Townsend, Maryland 21286. You can give online, mountcalvaryame.org, mountcalvaryame.org. Go to the Give tab, and you can click it, and you can give. You can use your mobile app, and you can go to Cash App, and you can give $MCAMEC. That's $MCAMEC, or you can go to Giveify, and you can give electronically. Or you can simply call it in using your credit card, your debit card, 410-296-9474. Ask for Sister Ursula. She'll be happy to assist you in your giving, because you can't beat in giving, no matter how you try. Shall we give God thanks for the gifts that we have received? All things.
Lord, bless his holy name. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, somebody to bless the Lord today. All of my steps in your word. All of my steps in your word. The steps of a good man, the steps of a good woman, they are ordered by the Lord. God, we thank you today. Now, God, consecrate me now to thy service. By the power of grace divine, let my soul look up with a steadfast hope, and my will be lost and down. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. This morning I want to call your attention again to the passage of scripture that was read earlier in your hearing. It's coming from Acts chapter 17 and one of the little verse 6 for our consideration today. Acts chapter 17, verse 6. Reading from the New King James Version of the Bible, these are the words that are recorded in Acts chapter 17, verse 6. But when they did not find them, they dragged Jason and some brethren to the rulers of the city, crying out, "These who have turned the world upside down have come here too." For a few minutes, I simply want to tag this text for preaching, "You can turn the world upside down." You can turn the world upside down. Ever since God banished Adam and Eve from the Garden of Eden, the world has been in a state of despair. But throughout the Old Testament, it tells the story of a broken relationship between a brokenhearted and a loving God with a sinful covenant-breaking people. And even today, as we look around as New Testament saints, we can see that there is more despair than hope, more discord than unity, more hate than love. Day in and day out, our souls are tried, our faith is tested, our testimony is scrutinized. This is a time when gun violence is at an all-time high. This is a time when families are becoming disjoined and drugs are indeed running free on our streets. It seems as though there is no relief in sight, no light at the end of the tunnel, no watchman on the wall. But even in a time such as this, I want you to know that we as Christians can still turn the world upside down. Because the fact of the matter is, the world desperately needs to be turned upside down. And of course, from the Christian perspective, turning the world upside down simply means turning the world right side up. And beloved, when we read the book of Acts, tells us exactly how we can do as Paul and Silas were able to do in turning the world upside down, so much so that news began to travel. Beware of Paul and Silas, because they have a way of turning the world upside down. The book of Acts tells us the incredible history of what happened after Jesus' death, resurrection, and ascension, and how his followers turned the world upside down. These believers in the first century church take on a world that is tired, troubled, and tangled. In today's text, in Acts 17, Paul, along with his friend and co-missionary Silas, have just been released from the Philippi jail. They had been released from the Philippi jail by the power of God. And after a midnight prayer meeting, after that miracle of God at midnight, and that jailhouse began to shake because God sent an earthquake to rock the jail, the jailhouse doors opened and the shackles broke loose, and it was such a powerful event in the life of the early church that a jailer and his whole family got saved that night. In the text, we see the undaunting spirit of Paul and Silas. And beloved, I wonder how many of us have that same type of spirit, a type of spirit that says nothing is going to stop me, nothing is going to slow me down from telling the world about Jesus. Sometimes I wonder, because when we suffer a setback, we get mad at God and we take a spiritual vacation. When we get our feelings hurt in church, we drop out or we quit or we refuse to support the life and the ministry of the church just to prove a point. But we got to have that same type of spirit that Paul and Silas had. Even when they were beaten, even when they were thrown in jail, they still were
did not allow those things to stop them or to turn them around, but they kept pressing their way. They kept telling the story. In our passage today, we encountered a crowd of people who charged some Christians with turning the world upside down. At the time of the text, the locals, along with the rulers of Philippi, they don't want Paul and Silas around. So Paul and Silas, they leave Philippi and they go to Thessalonica. And the text says that Paul goes into the synagogue, and for 3 Sabbath days, they reason with the people from Scripture concerning the Lord Jesus Christ. And as a result of Paul's preaching, many are converted and many are saved. And because many are converted and many are saved, the people, the rulers, the folk who do not know Jesus, do not believe in Jesus, they get upset. That's why you got to understand that even though they got converted and some got saved, everybody is not happy with people when they get saved. Everybody will not join in the praise party when folk get saved, because when people get saved, when people get filled with the Holy Ghost, when people decide that they're going to turn from their old ways and they're going to hold on to God's ways, the devil gets mad. Hell gets upset because people are being saved. And the text says in verse 5 that the Jews are not persuaded by the preaching of Paul and the conversion of those who have given their life to Christ. So because they are not convinced, they enlist some street gangs and they attack the house of Jason. They attack the house of Jason because they are looking for Paul and Silas. The Bible says they break down the doors of Jason's house, but upon entering Jason's house, they discover that Paul and Silas are not in the house. So because Paul and Silas are not in the house, they drag Jason and some of the converts out of the house and into the street of the city. And they say, these are they who have turned the world upside down, and they have come here to do the same thing. So the question is, how did the early church disciples turn the world upside down? What was the secret of their success? But more important, how can we turn the world upside down for the advancement of the gospel? I believe that they turned the world upside down first because they remembered who they represented. And my brothers and sisters, if you're going to turn the world upside down for the Lord, you got to remember who you represent. The all-consuming desire of the early church was to introduce others to Jesus Christ, the one who died on the cross. They were absolutely unconcerned about everything in the world but one thing, and that one thing was the teaching and the preaching of Jesus Christ. They expounded on the person of the cross. The world's transformation doesn't come by jealousy, defiance, and political upheaval. But the world's transformation comes through the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's why you have to be careful who you listen to. Regardless of the person's position. You must be careful of the conversation that you allow in your life. A lot of folk have been confused and drawn off by enticing words because we hear so much that is being masqueraded under the name of religion. It may sound good. It may sound right. But careful inspection reveals that it's nothing more than clinging black brass and a tinkling cymbal. We hear people using religion to push political agendas. Be careful of people who claim to love us but want to build more jails for us. Be leery of people who speak of God about in banning abortion but will not support babies that they have forced to be born in this world. Watch enticing words. Don't be drawn in by the lure of faith and caught by the hook of the political agenda. Remember who you represent. You represent him. You can't be too cool when you represent him. You can't be too sophisticated to serve him. You can't be too proud to participate to serve him. You can't be too opinionated to say amen to serve him. You got to recognize and remember who you represent. If you're going to turn the world upside down, you must not only remember who you represent, but you must pray. The early church knew how to pray. And beloved, you are no stronger than your prayer life. You are no stronger than your prayer life. If you expect God to do miraculous things for you, you got to pray. For prayer is not an escape from responsibility, but rather it is your response to God's ability. Yeah, it's not an escape from your responsibility, but prayer is your response to God's ability. In prayer, you can bring your every care to God in prayer. Your frustration, your feelings, your failures, your fears, your doubts, when hearts are stony, when people are mean, when situations are hopeless, when circumstances are helpless, all you got to do is pray. Because I declare that prayer will change stuff. Prayer will turn stuff around. Prayer will open doors for you. Prayer will heal sick bodies. Prayer will deliver sin-sick souls. I declare all you got to do is remember to pray. And when you pray, you can turn the world upside down because you got power. Prayer gives you power as a believer to turn the world upside down for the Lord. Yeah, you can turn problems into possibilities. You can turn opposition into opportunities. You can turn pain into power. You can turn sorrow into success. You can turn tears into triumph. You can turn grief into grace. You can turn stress into strength. Yes, when you pray, you can turn the world upside down. That's why David said, I will lift my eyes to the hills. So which cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord. And that's why every now and then you have to cry out, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, It's me, oh God, standing in the need of prayer. Not my mother, not my father, not my sister, not my brother, but it's me, oh Lord.
standing in the need of prayer. If you're going to turn the world upside down for the Lord, you got to pray. Finally, if you're going to turn the world upside down, you must have the anointing. The anointing is the power of God that is given to you by way of the Holy Ghost in order for you to do the will of God. The anointing is God's power that is releasing you by way of the Spirit so that you may bring glory and honor to God. The anointing is the smearing and the rubbing of the personality and power of God upon your life. Somebody in the house today, you know something about the anointing of God upon your life, because you realize that had it not been for the anointing of the Lord, then I declare that you wouldn't be here today. Had it not been for the anointing of God upon your life, you would have been torn into pieces. You would have been ripped into shreds. You would have fallen apart. But you know what the anointing can do. What your education could not do, your anointing did. What your charm could not deal with, your anointing did. What your social connection could not produce, the anointing of God did for you. Because you realize that the anointing destroys the yoke. Because if it had not been for the Lord on your side, where will you be today? You know it was nothing but the anointing, because the anointing gives you the power to stand when you want to sit down. And that's why Paul said, when you've done all you can do, when you can't do anything else, stand. Yes, your back may be up against the wall, but because you got the anointing flowing all over you, stand still, and see the salvation of God. So if you want to turn the world upside down, you got to have the anointing of Jesus all over you, because the anointing gives you power. The anointing makes everything all right. The anointing gives you clear vision. The anointing gives you sound hearing. The anointing of the Lord leads, guides every step of the way. I'm glad when you look at Paul and Silas, they turned the world upside down because they knew the Lord for themselves. And I want to ask you, do you know him for yourself? Do you know him? He's God's son. He's the King of kings. He's the Lord of lords. Do you know him? He's the sinner savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's the overseer of the overcomers. He heals the sick. He forgives sinners. He delivers captives. He saves lives. Do you know him? His name is Jesus. Yes, his office is manifold. His promises are sure. His light is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. Do you know him? His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. His yoke is easy. His burden is light. He had no predecessor, and he'll have no successor. You can't impeach him, and he's not going to resign. The Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they couldn't stop him. Pilate found no fault in him, but Pilate couldn't kill him.
death couldn't handle him. The grave couldn't hold him. His name is Jesus. Do we know him? The lily of the valley, bright and morning star, my way out of no way, water when I'm thirsty, food when I'm hungry, doctor in the sick room, lawyer in the courtroom, my way out of no way. Do you know him? Have you tried him? Will he make it? Will he make it? Will he make it all right? Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. I'm glad that I know he will. Yes. Yes. Yes, he will. Yes.
Paul and Silas turned the world upside down, and people knew it that they did. And as a result of the people's knowledge, the people sought to destroy them, but they would not keep quiet because, one, they knew who they represented. They represented Jesus Christ. There is no other name given under the heaven and on earth whereby men and women must be saved except by the name of Jesus Christ. So they knew who they represented, so they couldn't be quiet in spite of being beaten, in spite of being thrown in the Philippi jail. They couldn't keep quiet. As a result of their witness in chapter 16, as a result of their witness, as a result of them not keeping quiet, around midnight, the Bible says, Paul and Silas sang and prayed unto God. And the earthquake came and shook the jail. The doors came open. As a result of their witness, a jailer and his whole family got saved that very night. As a result of their witness, because they would not keep quiet, the people say they have turned our town, the world, upside down. And they have come here to do the same thing. They have come to Thessalonica to do the same thing. We heard about them, what happened in Philippi. Now they come in here to do the same thing, and we will not allow it. So they went to Jason's house, and because that's where Paul and Silas were hanging out, they were standing with Jason. But Paul had been preaching for three Sabbaths, and folk got converted. Folk got converted because of his witness. Because of his witness. Brothers and sisters, your witness means so much. Your witness is powerful. If you talk about God as much you talk about other stuff, look what can happen. You can turn the world upside down. Yeah. So they turned the world upside down because they knew who they represented. They turned the world upside down because they knew how to pray. They prayed. I think a few Sundays ago I told you about my little home church that those brothers and sisters, that they prayed the same prayer, but folk got saved on those same prayers. Week after week they heard the same prayer, but they shouted on those prayers because they believed in what they were saying. That's all they knew. That's all they knew, but it was enough. It was enough for them. So they continued to pray. They continued to pray. They prayed because they knew that there was power in prayer. Even if you have to say the same prayer over and over again, you got to understand that there's power in your prayer. You can have a fancy everyday prayer, a different prayer every day, but with no power, and nothing is going to happen because all you're doing is just saying words that sounds good. But I declare that when you mean that prayer from your heart and it's prayed from your heart, when they pray for you, you got power. You got power to turn the world upside down. And the anointing on their lives. The anointing made a difference. That's why they were able to stand. That's why they were able to continue to press on and to continue to witness, because they had the anointing of God upon them. They knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that they were saved. And it really didn't matter to them whether they lived or died, because they knew where they was going. It was far better than where they was at that particular time. My brothers and sisters, you had the opportunity today to become a soul winner for Jesus Christ. Yeah. If you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you can accept him today. And by your acceptance of Jesus Christ into your heart today, that will serve as a witness that Jesus is alive and well. And that if he can change you, he can change anybody. So my brothers and sisters, if you're here, you're not saved, we invite you to come. If you need a church home, I would love to be your pastor. The members of Mount Calvary would love on you, help you grow, become everything that God has created you to be. If that's you today, come down now. Put in the chat, I won't be long. If by chance you got mad with God, you got mad with church because something happened in church, but you can come back to God, you come back to church. And when you come back to God in church, God's arms are open, the church's arms are open, God is welcoming you back, the church will welcome you back as well. The choir going to sing. If that's you, we invite you to come today.
Around for me.
The doors of the church are open, the invitation to Christian discipleship.
Around for me. Turn it around for me. Around for me, 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 turning around for me.
Listen, y'all.
Hey, you will always be like this. The Lord will perfect that concerning you. Sooner or later, he'll turn in your favor. He's turning around for me. Around for me, around for me, around for me, around for me, around for me. He's turning around for me, around for me, Lord, around for me. I know he's turning around for me, around for me. He's turning around for me, around for you. He's turning around for you. Last time for me. Around for me.
The doors open. Invitation to Christian discipleship is extended today.
Around for me. Turning around for me.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Church
praise
say amen.
Lord.
Church
praise
say praise
the Lord.
Church say praise the Lord. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise in the house today for what God is doing in this house. Amen, amen. We have Sister Potts and her
son who's coming to unite with the Mount Calvary Amy Church family. Amen, amen. They've been baptized. They love the Lord, and so they're coming to unite with our church family, and we are delighted that they are here. Amen. There's plenty of good room in my Father's kingdom, and we don't want you to be just become a pew member, but we want you to get involved in ministry here at Mount Calvary and find your niche in ministry so that the Lord can use you for his glory and for his honor. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's get our new members another hand. Amen. God bless. All right. Amen. God bless. Amen. And the Lord added to the church daily. Amen. So we praise God for the increase. We praise God for the increase. Just a few days ago, Brother Walker, John, Jerome, Brother Jerome Walker, called to the church, and he wanted to become a member of Mount Calvary. And so I took him in over the phone. Amen. So we welcome Brother Jerome Walker also to the family of Mount Calvary. Amen. Amen. And they will be going to new members' classes with Reverend Thomasine, and from there to full members. So we praise God for the increase of how God is blessing us. How God is blessing us. Amen. Amen. The Bible says that all heaven rejoices over one sinner that needs no repentance. Amen. That comes to repentance. So we praise God for the sessions that we have received this week. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, we are ready now to go into our service of Holy Communion. We invite all believers in Christ Jesus who partake with us in our Holy Communion. I pray that you have received your communion kit from the ushers. If you did not receive one, please raise your hand and the usher will be happy to give you one. As we stand all over church and singing our communion hymn, let us break bread together on our knees. And repenting your sin and loving charity with your neighbor, intend to lead a new life, following commandments of God, and walk from henceforth in the holy ways. make your humble confession to Almighty God. You may be seated. Gentle confession all together. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, or deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your great mercy has promised forgiveness of sin to all of them with heart of repentance and true faith turned unto you, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all of our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you in word and magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we shall of all times and all places give thanks unto you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your holy name, evermore praising you, saying, Holy,
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord Most High.
We do not presume to come to this your table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifolds and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose profit is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, and that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by his death and washed through his blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us.
Amen, 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 amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your tender mercy did give your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, who made that by his oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in this holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech you, and grant that we receive in these your creatures of bread and wine, according to your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he given thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise, at the supper, took the cup. When he given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, take, drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament that was shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Drink it in remembrance of me. The body of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that was broken for me on Calvary. I take, I eat, and I'm thankful that Jesus died for me. The blood of Jesus, my Savior's blood, when the blood of pigeons, heifers, bulls could no longer atone for the sins of humankind, Jesus shed his blood on Calvary. Blood that caused the poet to write, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. I take, I drink, I'm thankful. By coming to this table, I have renewed my covenant. I'll now rise and I'll take the name of the Lord with me. Before you, you have the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that was broken before, just for you. When he died on Calvary. Take, eat, feast in your heart, knowing that Jesus, he died to save you. The blood of Jesus. The Savior's blood that was shed for you on Calvary. Take, drink, feast in your heart, knowing that his blood washes away all of your sins. By being partakers in the Lord's Supper on this day, you have declared that you're going to live a new life. That you're going to follow the commandments of God. Amen. Lord's Prayer together. Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we, your humble servants, desire your fatherly goodness, merciful to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching you to grant that by the merits and death of your Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and your whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all the other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto you, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto you, humbly beseeching you that all who are partakers of this holy communion may be filled with your grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto you any sacrifice. Yet we beseech you to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto you, O Father, almighty, world without end. Amen. 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 As we stand all over the church, joining and singing our hymn of fellowship, time is filled with swift transition. Naught on earth a move can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal.
hold to God's unchanging hand.
Time is filled with swift transition.
It's been a mighty, mighty good day, and we praise God for it, and we praise God for you. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. And now, beloved, may the Lord bless you and keep you in your going out and in your coming in. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you in your labor and in your leisure. May the Lord be gracious unto you in your joy and in your sorrow. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you in your laughter and in your tears. May the Lord give you peace that surpasses all understanding today, tomorrow, and forever. So, beloved, go in peace, go in love, go expecting a miracle from God today. And the people of God said together,
thank you for engaging in the ministry of giving. You can go to our website and click the Give tab. You can call the church office and give your gift with your debit or credit card. You can mail your gift to the church. You can bring your gift to the church during office hours, Tuesday through Friday, 10 to 4 p.m. You can give through Cash App on your smart device. Thank you for joining our virtual worship experience, and may God continue to bless and keep you. Until the next Lord's Day, be well and be safe.